Okay, today we're going to talk a little bit about wear sensors on brake pads. Now, many manufacturers still use this, but this is our original wear sensor here. It's a piece of metal that we actually is incorporated into the backing plate or sometimes in the shim. And what that piece of metal does, it protrudes past the backing plate. In this case, about 3 millimeters. So when those brake pads get to within 3 millimeter of that backing plate, that piece of metal will start rubbing on the rotor. Now it makes a real high-pitched squealing noise. You've probably heard it before on vehicles either driving past you or your own vehicle. And sometimes the noise goes away when you hit the brake pedal. What you're doing when you're hitting the brake pedal, you're actually pushing that sensor up against the rotor and deadening the noise. It actually makes more noise when you're not hitting the brake pedal. So this was one of our first ways to warn you when your brake pads were getting down. Now, then they came out with electronic sensors. Now, the electronic sensors in the old days were basically just a single wire looped, and it was monitored by a module on the dashboard, and it just was really resistance. So that wire had a set resistance, typically around 2,000 ohms, and it was embedded in the head of the sensor here, and it was right up against the brake pad, right, real close to the rotor. And when the pad would get worn down thin, that rotor would start rubbing on that piece of plastic and break that wire. Once that wire was broke, the resistance value changed, and it would kick on the light on the dashboard. Now, a lot of guys never replace those sensors. They take the two wires and twist them together, and a lot of people did it that way. But now BMW a few years ago came out with what they call a two-stage sensor. This is actually two complete sensors mounted in one head. And what it does is the one wire senses about 50% when your brake pads wear down to about 50%, and it doesn't trigger a light on in most cases. It just tells the computer that you are down 50% on your brake pads. And there's a second sensor in here then that will warn when it's down to about the same thing, about 2 or 3 millimeter left. It'll kick on and it'll bring a light up on the dash. But the information that it's giving the computer is telling the computer inside the vehicle that my brake pads are worn 50%. Now it starts monitoring things like miles, like brake pedal pressure. It can monitor that, can even monitor brake, the rotor temperature in some cases. So all that information goes into the computer to determine how good a shape your brakes are in. Now, one more thing, Mercedes and a few other companies that use electric parking brake, they can actually use their parking brake motor to monitor pad thickness. If you think about this, all they have to do is count how many times that motor, that little stepper motor, turns out to apply the back brakes, and they can actually figure out how much pad life is left on your pads. But now that only goes to the back pads, so they still usually use a sensor on the front pads. Now I'm going to go ahead and put the new sensor on this BMW. Okay, I've routed the sensor now. It plugs in actually over here. I routed it through the factory. That's an important step, is route it through all the holders that are here along here, the retainers, because you don't want this wire rubbing up against the tire, because it will set the light on. In fact, the very last holding facility here is your the little cover on your bleeder. So I'm gonna put that in there, cover that. Now, this end right here is the sensor end. This fits into a slot on the backing plate or the inboard pad. It'll sit on the backing plate. I'll slide it in there, and it'll actually be, if I can show you up close, it'll be quite a distance from the rotor now, because we've got brand new pads on here. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this in here.